The Prostate Cancer Results Study Group has reviewed studies covering 83,565 patients, a total of 242 studies, some for as long as 15 years. Of that group, 30,609 patients, data from 62 studies were identified in the low-risk group. This tutorial will cover the low-risk comparison chart for prostate cancer treatments. The treatments on this chart are surgery, external beam radiation, seeds or brachytherapy, the combined treatment of brachytherapy and external beam radiation, proton radiation, high-dose rate radiation, and high-intensity focused ultrasound. Note that the high-dose rate radiation and high-intensity focused ultrasound do not have enough data points to make up an ellipse, but the data is included for completeness. To understand more about low-risk prostate cancer and the treatment options, select a low-risk commentary. Here you will find a description of the disease and an overview of the options for low-risk patients. To view the results of a treatment, select the square next to the treatment name. For example, selecting surgery causes a series of dots and squares to appear on the page along with the ellipse. Each dot or square represents a study with a different number of patients. To learn more about a particular study, hover over the dot. If you click on the dot, a link will appear that will take you to an abstract of the study. To see the entire list of reference articles on this page, click on the low-risk article reference link. Here you will find a link to all the studies covering the 30,609 patients used to create the low-risk chart. The scale on the left-hand side of the graph is percentage of PSA progression-free. Measuring PSA progression-free, as opposed to survival, is a true indicator of the success of the treatment. A PSA progression-free of 100% implies that the cancer has not returned and no follow-up treatment was necessary. The bottom of the graph tracks time in years, in this case up to 16 years. The longer a treatment can maintain a PSA progression-free close to 100%, the more effective the treatment. The treatment ellipse is mathematically calculated to help you visualize how the patients are doing with the selected treatment. The midpoint of the ellipse shows on average how the patients responded to that treatment. The direction of the ellipse shows how the patients trended over time. To learn more about the process behind creating the ellipses, just click on How the Charts Work. If you choose to focus your study on just one treatment, you can deselect the others on the chart. This capability also works within the key. You can change the data presented by selecting or deselecting them in the key. In the case of surgery, there are two types of surgery represented by the ellipse: radical prostatectomy and robot surgery. Using the key, you can focus on one or both by viewing just the data points. If you are unfamiliar or would like to understand more about a treatment, click on the treatment name and the treatment description page will appear. Here you will find descriptions of all the treatments being compared on the graph. In the upper right-hand corner of the chart are the options to print or download the current page reflecting the treatments you have currently selected. With all treatments selected, this graph displays the results representing 30,609 patients from 62 different studies with prostate cancer and their treatment results, some of them for a period of over 15 years.